tour was really interesting, don't you think?
Detectives, it's Edward. Look, something strange happened again. Susan Winehouse was kidnapped right in the middle of the day in the mall. Could you please go and investigate? There were no witnesses, and the police seem to be getting nowhere.
I'm always ready to go, but you probably need to get your stuff together, Randall. I'll pick you up later. Before you go, there's something I made for you in my purse.
Look, everything's logged since our first Monday at work.
How many moons have passed? I've almost forgotten.
Almost forgot how much I'd done.
Huh. Are you getting bored without any bruises? I'll quickly fix this.
What are you gonna do? Lay out your cards? Or put a hex on your brother? Nah, just kidding. We both did a great job. I just contributed more.
Do you remember the case with the actress? I've told you like 1,000 times that paranormal is cool.
Yeah, you're right. That wasn't easy. Lifting fingerprints is outdated.
My pendant actually helped you find those fingerprints, remember?
How could I forget? When you opened your third eye, I didn't know what to do with my scientific approach.
Oh well. Susan's husband. I think you should check the crime scene one more time, Randall. Maybe the police is missing something.
Thank you. Officer Schopenhauer asked me to fill you in. A couple was on a date. The man went for coffee for him and his girlfriend. The witness is told that the man in the mask was taking her away. He searched everywhere for her, asked visitors and security, watched the records. Nothing. The police checked and couldn't find any clue as well. Now you may go.
We only didn't get to see the second floor. It was blocked off right away, and we haven't had a chance to check it out yet. Would you like to examine it? I understand. I won't disturb you anymore.
Someone deliberately removed the fingerprints from the database. It's gonna be harder to see who they belong to. We'll get to the bottom of this, one way or another. So, her husband Dave goes for coffee. Susan is sitting on the bench. Then the criminal comes to the bench. Susan greets him. She doesn't scream, so maybe she knows him? At any rate, he uses a rag with chloroform and takes her away while Dave is busy. Dave comes back, doesn't find Susan, calls the police.
Bravo, Detective. You're still missing some of the investigation. I left something special for you. Have fun. Detective, the more you untangle, the more you'll understand the importance of your role. We're all involved in this as well as Dave. I sent him something that reveals the next move.
Elena, I found the record in the mall. The criminal said that he sent a parcel to Dave. Not just a blackmailing or ransom, it's something more. He intentionally left all these clues and knew his victim. Please ask Dave about everything. Be careful, sis.
This is a warning.
Thank you. better give it up.
Who are you? Sorry. I just got scared it might be that madman who kidnapped my wife. I just can't open this package. I fear the worst. I'm sorry.
Susan is fine. For now. Dave, you need to pass a test proving that your love for Susan cannot be compromised. Find the abandoned part. If Dave succeeds, Susan will stay alive. If not, well, you know what awaits her.
Hurry! We must find that abandoned amusement park. I'll meet you at the car. I don't have a choice. I have to pass this test to save Susan. You're getting in my way, Detective. I'm sorry.
Find the clue I left for you here in the park if you wish to meet in person. I'll wait for you in the hut. If you fail this simple task, well, you're not worth playing with.
brother is already playing my game. And Dave's life depends on him, just as Suzanne's life depends on you. She's in my warehouse. Good luck finding her, Eleanor. So, you've passed my test. Now, hurry to the warehouse.
Be careful. I don't have much energy to talk, but I'll give you an advice. There's a garage near the warehouse where Ethan's car is parked, and there my belongings in the trunk, including my diary. What a pity.
so far.
But the real challenge is yet to come. I've rigged the warehouse to explode if you attempt to escape. So don't you go anywhere.
I still have plans for you.
Thank you.
Boom.
And don't forget, someone else's life depends on you too.
Thank you. You're free. As for us, Eleanor, I think it's time to go somewhere new.
Welcome, Randall. You better start looking for a way into the house if you want your sister to live.
Thank you.
on Dave's fate. Only you can decide what happens next.
said if
I couldn't do it.
He would stop looking
for
it.
Then he said he had a backup plan.
Thank you for coming after us.
Dave! I'm free. I'm okay. But Ethan got Eleanor.
You're willing to go through anything I put you through to save your sister. A loving heart like yours is exactly what I'm looking for. I'm waiting at my mansion. I'll send you the address. Eleanor is in my room. Hurry, if you want to save her.
I've found some strength to appear in your world to warn you of danger. Ethan is very dangerous, and I've already warned your sister. There's a secret room in this house. Only a few people know about it. Please, visit it to learn more about my husband. As you wish.
Yeah.
motivation for you.
Thank you. Whose heart is more loving, yours or Randall's? Either of you should work for the ritual, but I only need one. Everything's ready. All that's left is to choose which of you will die. Well, detectives, why don't I let you decide who's going to sacrifice themselves?
This would be a good time for your psychic powers, sis.
I can't believe we got through that. Love is one of the most powerful forces on Earth. It can push people to do desperate, crazy things.